I step outside and see a garden full of flowers and bees. Houses full of happiness, neighbors chatting away. I see the TV, the news. A new war, a bombing, a country being torn. Why, I think, why make someone cry? Be nice, just try. I walk outside but want to run to the country without no sun. The place where families stay inside. Instead of seeking, they need to hide. No joy, no smile, just worries, tears, fear for miles. Then I stop. I can't fight alone. I'll be knocked down like crumbling stone. But that doesn't mean I can't help. My voice is small but not mute. I'll make it heard for the change. I want to fly to the bombing to stop the pain and lakes of sobbing. I jump and jump but fall and think, I can't stop a bombing. I'll fall down even harder than before, but I'll use this passion for a change. I can stop another shooting. I dream and believe, but I don't forget. I don't think you've met my passion, my hearts, my dreams. So call me a kid, but I'll be big. My voice is small, but not mute. I'll change the world. The world will change.
What if your home was to be chopped down? You ran away to where tranquility was found. Got taken to a factory to be turned into a chair. The machine started up and polluted the air. The last tree came down with the final chop, hit the ground with a loud plop. Nothing for miles, just dirty piles. Don't you remember what the Lorax said? Aren't those words in your head? What if all the trees were to come down? Wouldn't you feel the earth frown?
He came here to practice his religion, but then it became a hard mission. This is not a matter to jest, and it's not his fault this isn't his nest. He sits in class silently, and people stare at him awkwardly. He sits feeling hurt and alone, but all people would think about is his hairstyle and cologne. He's alone when he eats lunch, and wishes that he could join the bunch. And people should know that just because he listens to different songs doesn't mean he's wrong, and just because he doesn't blend in the crowd doesn't mean he shouldn't be proud. And if he's white or black, he shouldn't feel that something about him lacked. These people all have different beliefs, and that's what makes us unique. Because if we're all the same, believe me, it would be lame.
As I look at tiny ones and zeros, for some odd reason, I am entertained. With the virtual horde of hectic action, I sit mesmerized by the fake reality. Totally fiction, I play as a hero to save the day on the screen in which I play. Some people play for their whole life and they don't even realize their life has walked out the door. The fake terrain of the game appeals more to me than reality, which is insane because after all, it's only ones and zeros.
I might not be able to see with my eyes, but I can conspicuously perceive with my heart. I might not be able to hear with my ears, but I can hear from afar. I might not have a nose as sharp as a dog, but I can smell very well. I might not have the smartest tongue, but I can talk and tell. I might not be a professional singer, but I can hit the notes. I might not be able to eat 1,000 hot dogs, but my stomach's not as big as boats. My arms might not exhibit the strongest things, but at least I have them on. I might not be able to write poetry, but I don't use my hands to con. I might not have fast, lofty legs that go at the speed of light, but they have an innate talent to help me walk with all my might. I might not have the perfect shoes, but my feet are enough. Designer shoes are perfect, pretty, and precious, but my feet have all the love. From top to bottom, you can see I might not be model ready, but I have won the race by being original and steady.